This is Today in St. Louis, focused on you.
All right, wake up, St. Louis. Just 4 hours ago, Santa and his reindeer took flight, kicking off one of the most magical days of the year. Thanks to NORAD's radar, we can see Santa is delivering gifts in China right now. He'll reach the bi-state sometime between 9 p.m. and midnight. So, you know what that means? It's time to get to bed.
Yeah.
We don't want to see him delivering anything, do we?
No, no, we don't. 9 o'clock, that's an early bedtime for some of us.
That is, that's true. And you can see we're all ready for Santa too here at 5 on your side. Good morning to you. It's Christmas Eve or Sunday, December 24th, whichever works for you. I'm Travis Cummings here with Tracy Hinton. Mercedes McKay has the day off, spending some much needed time with family.
Yeah, and these cookies definitely don't look like Famous Amos from the bakery.
We were trying to figure, are they grandma's? We're trying to figure it out. But regardless, we know Santa is going to eat them.
Yeah, still good. Yeah. Still good.
And he's going to have some decent weather as he makes his rounds.
Especially if he comes before midnight, because we are going to see rainfall come in pretty late for us tonight. The fog is already starting to lift. If you were up early with us, you saw some of that fog. We have some scattered, very light, very minimal showers out there right now, but it's this system that is off to our west that we are watching here, and that's going to slide in and impact us overnight. Currently, it is a beautiful start to the day. We do have some sunshine, a bit more than yesterday. It is 56 degrees outside. Winds are out of the east, southeast at 11 miles per hour. Through the rest of our day today, we will make it into the low 60s. Good mix of sun and clouds until the afternoon. In the afternoon, we're going to have more cloud cover push in and over us. Tonight, we will have a soaking rain. It is set to arrive pretty late, though, 54 degrees for us. Winds will gust up to 25 miles per hour. Now, coming up, I will outline what you can expect in the 7-day forecast, which includes more seasonable temperatures.
All right, thank you, Tracy. Well, here's a look at the fog conditions while you were sleeping. From the Stan Musial Bridge to the JB Bridge, you can see visibility there was quite low. It's especially low as you head east on 64 towards Illinois, where the highway rises up near Jefferson. Take it slow on the roads as you go out today, folks. And it was a deadly start to Christmas Eve in St. Louis City. The first homicide happened a little before 3:30 this morning on Talmadge, just a block north of Shodo. Right now, all we know is police found the victim unconscious with a gunshot wound to the chest. And just 1 minute later, and a bit south, another person was shot and killed in South St. Louis. It happened a bit before 3:30 a.m. at Minnesota Avenue and Potomac Streets, just south of Cherokee, right by Gravoy Park. No word on any suspects there. And this morning, a St. Louis man is in police custody after disappearing last week. Police found him in Racine County, Wisconsin yesterday. A family member reported 31-year-old Trenton Ivey missing on December 20th. He was last seen with 29-year-old Markeisha Williams in North St. Louis. Ivey faces multiple charges, including use of a dangerous weapon, resisting an officer, and fleeing from an officer. We reached out to the Racine County Sheriff's Office to find out if Williams was with Ivey when he was arrested. We'll update you when we get back to us. But right now, division is growing over the Francis Howell School Board's decision to strike Black History electives from their curriculum. Since the board meeting Thursday night, 5 on Your Side has covered the controversial vote. I spoke with community members, local leaders, and academics on both sides of the issue.
To not allow students to see themselves in their classrooms, to not have their history, their work, their past, their families, their people represented in their classrooms. That's what this is about.
It's a fallout over the future.
Let them learn!
Emotions run high after the Francis Howell School Board decided to drop two Black-related electives from its curriculum at three of its high schools.
These courses were put in place to teach students about Black history, Black literature, that prepares them to be better workers in the workforce, to be better, more empathetic, compassionate humans.
Walker, a former student, says she didn't feel that unity on campus.
I experienced a lot of racist incidents when I was at Francis Howell North, so I chose to go to St. Charles Community College instead.
St. Charles County Councilman Mike Elam says the move could be a better way to see success in schools.
It's probably better pursued at a college level than it is at a high school level, because today in public education, we really need to focus on core development.
Statements from board members indicate it's not the history they want to get rid of, but the place where it's coming from, which is the social justice standards developed by the Southern Poverty Law Center. The board cites it teaches through a more, quote, social justice framework. Dr. Willie Francois weighed in on that notion.
Despite our racial identifications, despite our class backgrounds, to learn Black history is to learn a fuller story of the American project. And it invites us into being a part of making this a more perfect union. If that's turning people into activists, I guess I'm okay with that.
That perfect union, many agree, everyone's experiences should exist in.
Because the real world is diverse.
Travis. Well, we have reached out to the Southern Poverty Law Center to get their response to the board's concerns about their work. We are waiting to hear back.